We're driving the Lotus Elise and the Mazda RX-8 because they're dying for 2012, and they're both very great cars. They're both unique because they're such pure driver's cars, and there's nothing comparable to either one. They don't compare to each other either. The RX-8 is a rotary engine vehicle, and there's nothing else out there with a similar powertrain. You can spin it up to 9,500 RPM. It's so smooth, so visceral, just feels so good, and you can't help but every time you get on the throttle to just take it all the way to 9,500 RPM. You can't be short shifting at 6,000, 7,000, 8,000. Take it all the way to redline. The Elise is purity in an automobile defined, and it will teach you so many things about a car that you didn't understand until you've been behind the wheel of an Elise. Mid-engine, rear-wheel drive, low power, so it's all about momentum, keeping the engine revs high, and picking the right line on the track, and just finding that zen moment where you are perfectly connected with the machine, making your way around the track fluidly, and just feeling the moment. It's really an incredible car. The RX-8 is leaving the market simply due to low sales. There's a lot of competitors out there in that segment, and the one thing Mazda kind of messed up with the RX-8 was they didn't build a successor to the RX-7. They didn't build another sports car. They made a Grand Tourer, and it didn't really resonate with the market. It was certainly appreciated and well received when it debuted, but going on 6-7 years, sales have totally slumped, totally fallen off, and it's just going away. The Lotus is leaving the US market, but it's not gone for good. It's still gonna be sold in Europe. And it has to leave the US because Lotus had an exemption from the government to sell here with simple airbags. And that exemption expires, meaning Lotus would be required to fit more complex, dual stage, smart airbags. And that's just too expensive for the low volume that the Elise sells in. These cars are icons in automotive history. They are significant points on the timeline, starting from the development of the car, way out into the future, 50 years from now, 60 years from now, they'll be in books. There will be TV shows about them. There will be fan pages on the internet devoted to them. There will be owners clubs where people just cherish these, and there will be auctions where they sell for way more than they're worth right now. They're just such unique items, such unique cars. There's nothing else out there like them that really defines this moment, 2011, in history, automotive history. So, you know, they've earned a spot in our heart, and they've earned a spot in the history books as well.